All right, Reading Rainbow, episode 40, The Runaway Duck. One morning, Sebastian Willowfrost was playing in the garage. He was rolling Egbert, his favorite toy, around on the floor. Egbert was a carved wooden duck with wheels and a long nylon string for pulling. The wheels were mounted on metal axes and rolled very smoothly. One wheel had a plaque on which Sebastian had written his name. Suddenly, Sebastian's father, Albert Willowfrost, called him in for lunch.
"Just a minute,"
cried Sebastian. Sebastian tied Egbert to the bumper of his father's car so that he couldn't roll away. Lunch was sandwiches and soup. Sebastian's father ate quickly, wiped his face with a napkin, kissed Sebastian's mother goodbye, and hugged Sebastian. He was going on a long business trip and wouldn't be back for a week. Sebastian forgot that Egbert was tied to the bumper of his father's car. By the time Sebastian remembered, Egbert was doing 60 miles an hour down Route 95. The road was rough, and Egbert bounced all over. Racing around a sharp mountain turn, Egbert's tie string broke. Egbert sailed off underneath the guardrail and into empty space. For 10 seconds, Egbert flew like a real duck, but then he fell down, down, down into Emerald Valley. Luckily, Egbert fell into a stream, where he was carried forward by the force of the water. The fish in the stream thought this was funny, such as a strange duck with wooden wheels. Egbert rolled and floated on, past Steelberg, Bottleberg, Carberg, and Burgerberg, out into Bertobomb Bay and the sea. An eagle-eyed sailor on board the SS Rover spotted Egbert and tried to rescue him, but a sudden typhoon drove the ship away. Meanwhile, Sebastian prayed that Egbert was safe and that he might return. He wrote several poems in memory of Egbert and tried to forget the whole tragedy by playing baseball with the Indian family from across the street. One night, in early September, Egbert was attacked by a shark. The shark pulled Egbert down into the ocean. He bit off one of Egbert's wheels, discovered that it was wood, and swam away in disgust. Egbert floated up past a clownfish, a sea turtle, and a pufffish. The wheel floated up alone. After some time, a wave tossed Egbert onto an almost deserted isle.
"Voila! Un canard!"
cried Jacques Vivian, poet, shipwreck survivor, and Frenchman. This is French for,
"Whoopee! A duck!"
Jacques wrote a long poem about Egbert called Song to a Duck. The poem begins, "Oh, what luck to find a duck upon a desert isle. He's missing a wheel and his paint's all peeled. But nevertheless, he smiles." Time passed slowly. Sebastian and Jack continued to pray and write poems. One night, a shooting star brightened Jack's island, and Sebastian awoke from the middle of a dream. The next day, sailors on a French merchant vessel spotted Jack and carried him and Egbert to France. There was much excitement over the castaways. The president of France met the ship at port. Le Monde, an important French newspaper, published a photo of Egbert and a copy of Jacques' poem. Sebastian happened to see Egbert's picture at a local newsstand while buying some gum. He immediately went home and wrote a letter to the president of France, enclosing an old photo of Egbert and a couple of poems. "Please," he wrote, "send Egbert home." Jacques was enjoying dinner when the French president showed him the letter, the photo, and the poems. Jack tossed his napkin on the table and stood up.
"But this is my duck," Jack cried.
Why? They are not the same. They cannot be. The president's daughter urged him to return the duck. Jack went for a long walk around the Eiffel Tower. He realized Sebastian's poems were better than his own, and that the wooden duck was probably Sebastian's after all. Meanwhile, the president's daughter checked to see whether Sebastian's name was on Egbert's right front wheel, as Sebastian claimed in his letter. Unfortunately, this wheel was now in Portugal, where a little girl was wearing it on a necklace. When he got back to the palace, Jack announced, "I will return the duck this evening by air post." The president's daughter kissed Jack on the cheek. Sebastian received the package and a letter 2 weeks later. Jack and the French president's daughter were going to be married. They invited Sebastian and his family to the wedding. Everything seemed perfect. Jack had been rescued. Egbert had returned, and the Willowfrost family would see a French wedding. Sometimes, though, Sebastian tried to imagine what had happened to Egbert's front wheel. And sometimes, far, far away, a little girl in Portugal wondered just who Sebastian Willowfrost was. The end.